Students, you are welcome again in this lecture of Science and Technology Part 2, and we are studying the chapter number 6, that is nothing but the animal classification. So, in the earlier period, we studied how the animal classification, it is carried out conventionally. So, but today we are going to see the criteria for the new system of classification. So, at present, according to the five kingdom classification, that system was introduced by Robert Whittaker, all multicellular animals, they are included in a kingdom Animalia. And this system of classification is based upon the criteria like the body organization, then the body symmetry, then the body cavity, then the germinal layers and the segmentation, etc. So, let us study them one by one. So, the important point which we are going to see today first is the criteria for new system of classification. Remember, there are various criteria which are taken in the consideration during the classification of animals. Among them, the first is grades of organization. So, as we know that the body of animals, it is made up of cells, and in case of the multicellular animals, many cells are performing the different functions in their body. While in unicellular animals, as their body is made up of a single cell only, all the functions they are performed by a single cell only. So the body organization of unicellular animals is referred as the protoplasmic grade. It is called as the protoplasmic grade. And in case of multicellular animals, if tissues are not formed, then the body organization is called as the cellular grade organization. What I am going to say, when there are the multicellular animals and tissue is not formed, as we know that the tissue is nothing but the group of cells which is having the similar structure and which performs the similar function also. So, the animals, they do possess the cells only, but the tissue is not formed, then it is called as the cellular grade organization. So, for example, the phylum Porifera is the example of the cellular grade organization. Here you can see some animals with the protoplasmic grade organization. Here amoeba and the paramecium. They live as a individual, but they are made up of a single cell only. Therefore, they are called as unicellular. And all the functions of that organism, it is carried out with the help of a single cell only. So, the amoeba and paramecium are the animals of examples of the protoplasmic grade organization. And just we discuss the cellular grade organization. You can see here the cycon is there, then the collar cells are there, then the spicules are there, amoebocytes are there, ostium is there, and non-living part is also there. So, remember, this is the cellular grade organization. The tissue is not formed there. But remember, in case of some animals, the cells, they come together to form the tissues, and with the help of which all the body functions are performed there. And such animals show the cell tissue grade organization. Example are the animals from the phylum Cnidaria. This is the cell tissue grade organization. Here you can see the jellyfish. It has the tissues, but the organs are not formed there. So, this is called as the cell tissue grade organization. Then there are some flatworms. They show the tissue organ grade organization. In such type of organization, the tissues are organized to form the organs. However, the complete organ system is not formed there. For example, the planaria is there. They do possess the tissues and the organs, but the organ system is absent there. So, this is the type of organization. As you know that, in the higher type of animals, which are remaining, all the animals, they show the organ system grade organization. For example, the human being, it is the higher level animal or the higher grade animal. Then, it do possess the brain, then the heart, then the liver, then the pancreas, then the muscles, then the bones, etc. And you know that, suppose the lungs are there. The lungs, they do form the respiratory system. So we can say it is the organ system grid organization. For example, brain, it forms the control system of human being. Therefore, it is called as the nervous system. So it is also the organ system grid organization. In this manner, some animals, they show different types of organization in them, which are called as the protoplasmic grid organization, then the cellular grid organization, then the cell tissue grid organization, then the tissue organ grid organization, and the organ system grid organization. Now, while using the criteria for new system of classification, as we saw earlier, the grade of organization is the important criteria. But remember, second important criteria is the body symmetry. It is nothing but the body symmetry. If we take the pictures of human body and the amoeba, and if we try to take an imaginary section through a specific plane of their bodies, so will we get the two equal halves? No. In the body of human being, we will get the equal half. But in the amoeba, we will not get. So the imaginary, in imaginary sense, if the body of any animal is cut through the imaginary axis of body, it may or may not produce two equal halves. So depending upon this property, there are different types of animal bodies. Among them, first is the asymmetrical body. Second is the radial symmetry. Then is the bilateral symmetry. Let us study what are the symmetries. Remember, in case of the asymmetrical body, there is no any such imaginary axis of the body through which we can get two equal halves. For example, amoeba is there, then the sponges are there, then the paramecium is there. We cannot divide the body into two equal parts through any axis. So this type of symmetry of body is called as the asymmetry. Then the next point is the radial symmetry. Remember, in the case of radial symmetry, the imaginary cut passes through the central axis, but any plane of the body, it gives two equal halves. Therefore, we can get the two equal halves in the body, like the starfish. In case of this animal, there are five different planes which are passing through the central axis. And central axis of what? Central axis of body. And through which we can get two equal halves. Then the third type of symmetry is the bilateral symmetry. In this type of symmetrical body, there is only one such imaginary axis of body through which we can get two equal halves. For example, insect, we can make two sections of insect into left and right, fishes, left and right, frog, left and right, birds, left and right, humans, left and right. So this is called as the bilateral symmetry. So in this manner, today we studied the symmetry of a body or the body symmetry as a important criteria for the new system of classification. So in this diagram, you can see how the asymmetrical body is there, how the radial symmetry is there, and how the bilateral symmetry. While studying the criteria for the classification of animals in the new system of classification, it is the important point which is taken to be in the consideration. It is nothing but the germ layers. So in this criteria, it is observed that the animal is having a diploblastic or the triploblastic. Now question may arise in your mind that what is the diploblastic and the triploblastic? So remember, in case of the multicellular animals, the germ layers, they are formed during the initial period of their embryonic development. What it means by embryonic development? Embryonic development means the initial stage of the growth of any organism. For example, the human baby, it is in the womb of mother. This is the embryonic stage, the stage before birth. So remember, in this period of embryonic development, and what is going to be formed there? The germ layers are going to be formed. And remember, the different tissues, they are formed in the body with the help of those germ layers only. So in case of some animals, only two germ layers are present, which are called as endoderm and the ectoderm. Endoderm is the internal layer and the ectoderm is the external layer. For example, cnidaria are the animals in which we can see there are only two germ layers. But remember, in most of the remaining animals, the three germ layers are there. And it is nothing but the ectoderm, means the external, then the mesoderm is the middle, and the endoderm is the internal. So in this type, we can classify the animals into the diploblastic, means having two germ layers, and the triploblastic, that means having three germ layers. Here in this diagram, you can observe that there are the diploblastic and triploblastic, that means the germ layers. So in the left side, you can see that the endoderm showing the red color layer, and the dead layer is the middle layer, and the ectoderm is the outer layer. In the diagram which is shown in the right side, you can see that endoderm is the inner layer, which is having again the red color. Middle green color layer is nothing but the mesoderm, and the outer layer is the ectoderm. That it means the left diagram, it shows the diploblastic organism, and the right diagram shows the triploblastic organism. So in this manner, today we studied various different criteria which are essential for the new system of classification. That was the grades of organization, then the second was the body symmetry, and the third was the germ layers, that is the diploblastic and the triploblastic. So we will stop here. In the next period, we will see the again some criteria which are used for the new system of classification of animals. So thank you very much.